Dave Melcher is going to teach us how to make a gourd birdhouse, just like this one right here. And it's not so hard, right?
No, it's not very hard at all.
And especially, you have how many hanging in your yard?
I have about 58 hanging in my yard.
58. Larry actually grows all his gourds. This is a really heavy, fresh one, right?
This is a picture of my gourd garden again. This one came out of my, it's actually hanging right there in front of the bench. That's the one that came from my house.
So beautiful. So this takes a year to dry?
A year, probably they'll dry by next spring, but really it's best to have them dry for a year. And how you'll know they're dry is if you shake and you hear the seeds rattling in.
And those seeds that are inside, these are the seeds that come out.
Right.
Those I can plant next year and they will grow.
Yep.
I'm doing this. I have a pergola that's like 300 feet long.
That's great. They'll grow
up
the fence.
With gourds.
Some people like to let them grow on the ground so the stem will bend over. Those were hung high, and that's why that stem's straight up.
Okay, well, whatever.
Well, let me tell you about how I clean these gourds. These gourds, we take them to a car wash and pressure wash them.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah, that's really interesting. When I'm at the car wash.
Put them in the back of a truck?
Well, no, I put them up against a concrete block wall.
But if you had a steam cleaner at your house, you could steam clean.
Right, a pressure wash, you can steam.
Yeah, I have one of those.
All right, let me show you how we make these holes.
Clean my gourds. Okay, so you take out a big circle.
Right. We did that with a jigsaw.
Okay.
And I've already done this so that these pieces will fit snugly.
Okay.
Now, this hole up here is for the vent.
Vent.
And then these two smaller holes is
there's
for
your
the
vent.
For it to hang on.
That goes in there?
Right. We'll just screw that in there.
Oh, and it actually just sort of...
Yeah, what this is a PVC 90, a Schedule 80 90 that you can just get at the local hardware store. And it's threaded on one end.
Instructions for this will be on our website at MarthaStewart.com, so don't freak out writing all this stuff down. That's good.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what this does, as this gourd gets hot, this is where the hot air comes in.
Yeah, you said that.
All right, so now we're gonna glue the entrance in.
Right.
This is a special entrance.
But where do you get that?
I get that from a friend of mine in North Carolina, Sandy Bunn, entrances.com on the internet.
Oh, entrances.com fits in a, is this a 4-inch or a 3.5-inch?
That's 4-inch sewer pipe.
4-inch sewer pipe. So you have to go to entrances.com to get that Starling excluder.
These are called Starling resistant entrance holes. This one is an excluder 2-inch.
Do we have to put any of the caulking compound?
Not for TV. We're just going to stick it right in there.
Polyurethane construction.
All right, so we're going to put that in there.
Okay.
Now, we need to go ahead and put the glue. You'll take this one. And do it just like me. We'll take the caulking gun.
Okay.
And we're going to glue this about like that all the way around.
Okay.
See how I did that about an inch away from the end?
Yeah.
All right, now I fouled these holes out perfectly so they fit nice and snug. Yeah, now if you'll put that in the front of the gourd, slide it in.
All right. Way?
Yep. Pretty much about that far. Now what we're going to do is take a look at it. Well, before the glue sets, I'm going to level that up, make sure that looks nice and level, and then we're going to look at it sideways like this, and mine looks pretty good.
Yeah.
Yours looks great, too.
Yeah.
And then later on, you can take a latex glove and wipe all that glue off.
I'll just do it like paper towel.
All right, now let me show you the access port. These access ports I made, that looks real good. That's exactly how we clean it off.
Okay.
These access ports are made from 4-inch sewer pipe, and I have staples in it that helps catch the threads. And these lids just screw on like this.
Yeah, this is great.
Now, once again, Purple Martins like it nice and dark, so inside there is a dark piece of paper. Now, we're not going to glue this for TV. We don't have a whole lot of time, but it's going to have glue on it. We're going to put it in just like that, all right? And we want to look inside, make sure that no light gets in because Purple Martins like it nice and dark in there. Yeah.
All right. Pretty black.
Now we want to put the vent in.
Okay.
Okay, we already did. I didn't do it on mine. Let's put the holes in, the hanging holes.
Okay.
All right, see this rubber tube
mine out. And then we're going to paint this all white, too, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Here's your hose.
Okay.
It goes right through there.
Yeah.
We're going to slide it through there. And what this hanging hose, what this does, it keeps the gourd from when it shakes in the wind, it keeps it from
rattling.
It keeps the wire from wallering out the hole. Now, we're going to stick this wire right through the hose.
And make whatever kind of attachment you want, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Yeah. Excellent.
Perfect. All right, now, you might say, where'd I get this wire? This wire here, I just went to a hardware store and got this big, It's not rocket science, but I just kind of look and see what the gauge wire is. But what we do here,
you strip it.
We strip the wire.
Yeah, so right. Why don't you just buy this kind of copper wire?
I use copper wire because copper.
No, but why don't you just buy copper wire? Like, this looks like about a 20 gauge or 22 gauge.
When I looked in the hardware store, I saw this.
That first.
Yeah, and I felt like the 2 foot long.
Might be cheaper. You have to look and see.
Yes.
So that, that's great. It all comes apart. Okay.
All right. Now, what we do here with these white plastic gourds, these are natural gourds, we're going to add some nest material.
So these are just white pine needles?
These are soft pine needles.
Yeah.
Purple martins like to have a lived-in look, and they feel safe. They feel like that purple martins have been here before, and they like a safe nest site. All right, now we got to put the lids back on.
And now we have to find the purple martins, or they have to find us.
That's right.
Okay.
Purple martins depend on
me. Now, are they going to come? If I hang this in my yard, do I guarantee myself that
if you get one pair, you know that you put it up in the right spot.
Okay.
And if you just attract one pair, more will come on.
More will come on. I'm going to hang a whole lot. Thank you very much, guys. I'm going to take a lot of time. I'll give you some more information on purple martins. And I'll link to this on the landlord. Go to our website, gourdspirits.com. Thanks, Emmy.